There was an article in the August 2004 Journal of Political Economy, which is one of the top, if not the very top, peer-reviewed academic journal in the field of economics, either the American Economic Review or the JPE, or all one and two in the eyes of most economists. And there was an article by one of the editors of the AEA. Co-authors are UCLA economists Harold Cole and Lee Ohanian. And the article is called New Deal Policies and the Persistence of the Great Depression, a General Equilibrium Analysis. And you read this article, and there's a lot of math and economic models in it, but the authors are, they sort of express surprise at what they discovered by studying this period of the New Deal. And I'll read you what they conclude. New Deal labor and industrial policies did not lift the economy out of the Depression. Instead, the joint policies of increasing labor's bargaining power, which I'm going to talk about in a minute, and linking collusion with paying high wages prevented a normal recovery by creating rents and an inefficient insider-outsider friction that raised wages significantly and restricted employment. The abandonment of these policies coincided with the strong economic recovery of the 1940s. So it took until 2004 for the mainstream of the economics profession to sift through the cloud created by all the mathematical models and the mumbo jumbo and the lingo of economics to take a look at what actually happened. And even then, they can't just take a look at what happened. They have to create a general equilibrium model to explain what happened. And it's just these models, in my opinion, is why they never understood what the heck did happen. Some of the language that they use in economics is a good example of why it's almost impossible to understand things like the Great Depression if you become a general equilibrium modeler. Let's see if I can find a good one here. Oh, yeah, I wrote in one of my publications that some of the theories written up by people like these guys in the JPE, they sort of look at the economy is kind of like a Frankenstein monster. And here's what they say. The weak recovery during the Great Depression, the weak recovery is puzzling because the large negative shocks that some economists believe caused the downturn, including monetary shocks, productivity shocks, and banking shocks, became positive after 1933. And so now I read this, I hear shocks, and I just, in my warped mind, I think of the movie Young Frankenstein, with Frankenstein sitting there being shocked into life. You know, and that's how economists talk. They try to shock the economy into life. And he talked about negative shocks caused the depression, and so they were sapping the energy from Frankenstein, laying there on the table with Gene Wilder hovering over him. But he says, you know, after 1933, these shocks became positive. What were these shocks? Government spending. Monetary inflation. So they tried to shock the monster into life, and guess what? It didn't work. You know, unlike the Frankenstein monster story, where it did work. And so they failed to shock the beast into becoming a living being once again. And how are they supposed to do this with various injections of government spending or easy credit? So they tried shocking him, and that didn't work. So they brought out the big needles and inject him, and it still didn't work. And I'm not making this up. They're using these words: injection, shock, they say that they would have expected a roaring recovery. Maybe you haven't all seen the movie, but you know when Frankenstein does come to life, he roars. Doesn't he make a big loud noise? But it's just ridiculous. And so you guys are PhD students in economics. You're just the beginning of having to learn all this stuff. Good luck. Good luck to you. But I think it's because of that kind of nonsense that, you know, how many years ago? Who has a calculator? From 1933, here's old Hazlitt. Immediately recognize that this is a government cartel scheme. What do cartels do? They restrict output. What happens when you restrict output? You restrict employment too, don't you? That's exactly what you do. And so you create more unemployment, not less. And these guys just discovered that because for a brief moment they got away from their macroeconomic models and looked at a microeconomics book, apparently, and said, hey, look at this, there's a section on cartels here. What does it say there? And they actually got it. They got what happened. And so